unite us in the Christian fellowship
by sharing the apostolic tradition of common ideals, worship, and service.
Guide us towards our holiness, which harmonizes every dimension of our being and prepares us for all good works.
Fill our hearts with your Holy Spirit, that we may promote the welfare of all as the body of Christ on earth.
And so pattern our lives each day according to Jesus, your Son.
In whose name we pray.
St. Norbert,
pray for us.
The St. Norbert College community respectfully acknowledges the past and present traditional owners of this land on which we are meeting, the Whadjuk people. It is a privilege to be standing on Noongar country. We acknowledge the contribution of Aboriginal Australians and non-Aboriginal Australians to the education of all children and people in this country we all live in and share together, Australia.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our presentation night for 2020.
Due to COVID-19, we weren't sure whether we could use the concert hall this year, and so we made the decision to film the night. As you can see, it's going to be very different, and well, that's not a bad thing.
Every year we have a theme for the night, and it's very fitting that this year's theme is adaptability.
Whoever chose that at the start of the year must have known something.
Well, we all know it's been a year that has been like no other, but tonight is not about looking at the things that haven't happened or couldn't have happened. It's about looking at, well, what we did do.
It's about being positive what we were able to achieve.
And it's about looking forward to what we can hopefully achieve in the future.
This year, you will be able to sit with your children and watch them possibly receive an award. We have kept a number of awards secret this year, so they will be a surprise to everyone. More about that later.
It's exciting and slightly scary to film this night, but we hope you sit back and enjoy the evening.
It is now our pleasure to introduce our principal, Mr. Simon Harvey, to give his principal's address.
What a year we've had.
Oh, it's been an amazing year. And who can believe that we're at the concert hall already?
You're going to be great tonight. Your speech is going to be amazing.
Oh, thanks very much, but it's not about me. It's all about the students. Mr. Dowling.
Mr. Harvey.
Just wondering if you read your email about the change of venue.
Oh, the email.
Oh, that's right, the email.
We'll be there in a jiffy.
Mr. Dowling.
Good evening to all out there wherever this broadcast finds you. It is always a special honour to present this address as the principal of St. Norbert College, albeit this year in a novel and unique way. I would first like to acknowledge Reverend Father Peter Joseph, Prior of our community, Father Stephen and Brother Kenneth, Brother John and Brother Stephen, parents, families and community members both in WA, interstate and abroad, and to our much cherished students and staff. We know this year has been a challenge, but I don't want to focus so much on what has been lacking this year or what we've missed out on, but rather what we have done, what we have achieved and what we have shared together. Tonight, I would like to begin by sharing a reflection from the history of St. Lawrence, who lived about 900 years before St. Norbert. The story goes of St. Lawrence that as Archdeacon of Rome, he held a position of great trust that included the care of the treasury and riches of the church and the distribution of alms to the poor. On an edict from the Roman authorities, Lawrence was commanded to hand over all of the riches. His response was to ask for 3 days to gather them all up. In that time, he hastily distributed the wealth and riches to the poor before they could be seized. Then on the third day, when he was ordered to present the treasures, Lawrence came to the meeting accompanied by the people, the poor and the suffering. In defiance for what was being asked, rather than handing over the riches, Lawrence declared that these people were in fact the true treasures of the church. Lawrence was immediately martyred for this act of defiance. In a similar way, we come together tonight to witness the true treasures of our college community. Yes, we'll be witness to speeches. Yes, we'll enjoy student performances. We'll be able to see who has achieved excellence in courses and college activities and programs. And yes, we acknowledge the contributions of many members of our community this evening. But when it comes to witnessing our treasures, it's not the prizes and the speeches, the performances, and whilst they are incredible and worthy of acknowledgement, it is the people of our community who are our real treasures. Respectful of the family behind the name, some of whom are members of our community, it is more than ironic that we reside on Treasure Road. It is not just our address, it points to more than that. and I wish to give a snapshot of some of our treasures this year and the hopes for 2021. As a faith-based community, we continue to focus on being a truly missionary centre of formation and evangelisation of our young people. We've continued to promote prayer and reflection, furthered the development of our religious education program and the empowering elements of our much envied and respected Christian service program, highlighted by the Kimberley immersion, which all seemed unlikely at the start of this year. As we look towards 2021 and the easing of physical distancing restrictions, we expect to return to joyful celebrations of our faith, such as whole school masses, feast days, and liturgical activities as a shared community. In an academic sense, it is absolutely incredible what our staff have been able to achieve in our teaching and learning program. It is widely regarded that what our staff were able to do in moving into the remote learning environment within a few weeks back in March would normally take governments and authorities years to introduce and enact. A pandemic can never be said to be timely, but as we progress into 2021, we look to take what we have learned from a teaching and learning perspective and develop our St. Norbert College Vision for Learning, a vision that encapsulates best practice, a framework from which we can visualise what our classroom environments should look like, feel like, and actually be like. How responsive our teaching is to the learning needs of our students, and creating environments and learning experiences for our students to achieve their true potential. All of this, of course, based on Christ-like relationships between staff, students, and families. As a community, we continue to strengthen our endearing relationship with the Norbertines. Christmas Day this year marks the 900th anniversary of the day that our patron Norbert founded the Order of Canons Regular of Premontre. Some 900 years later, there are more than 1,300 ordained men and women around the world. This, of course, includes our very own Father Peter, Father Stephen, brothers John, Kenneth and Stephen, and all of the much-loved Norbertines of Queen's Park who have entered into eternal life. We come to share in this educational apostolate known as St. Norbert College, a place that means so much to us all. Our sense of community is so central to that. In any given year, we cannot achieve, accomplish, succeed in what we do, if not for the people doing it, irrespective of any pandemic. In 2021, we hope not just to maintain, but to grow that sense of community and awareness of our heritage. Celebrating the 900th anniversary of the Norbertines is such a special part of that. It is a wonderful achievement, one that we will be sure to acknowledge, celebrate, and use as a reminder of who we are and where we come from. I thank Father Peter and the Norbertines, whose constant support and validation is life-giving. We are determined also to foster strong ties with members of our community. Special thanks to members of our College Advisory Board, led by Board Chair Mr. Bernie Kerwin, and to our Parent Committee under the leadership of Dr. Paul Costantino. Paul has informed me that he will be stepping down as Chair of the Parent Committee at the end of this year after 4 years of service. Thank you, Paul. We are indebted to you for your passion and hard work. Stewardship of our college campus is also very important. We must remain alert to sustaining, enhancing, and expanding a vibrant, contemporary educational facility for our students and staff. It's amazing the impact that new lockers has had on our vista, and we look forward to sharing further aspects of our capital development and maintenance plan with our community in the future. My heartfelt thanks to the staff of the college, all 103. Words fail me. I'm so proud and fortunate to be associated with our staff. Sadly, at this time of the year, we take the opportunity to farewell staff. This year, I'd like to acknowledge 5 staff members who individually have contributed many years of exemplary service to St. Norbert College. Mrs. Penny Mully, Dr. Alberto Runco, Mr. Brad Collins, Miss Susan Teo, and Miss Karis Hughes all begin a new chapter in 2021, but will always remain a special part of our community. In addition, we farewelled Mrs. Calogero Ronchi last week, who was expecting the arrival of her first child. To our parents, we never underestimate the challenges facing parents in the world today. We hope that whilst you may not always agree with our decisions, from an educational perspective, you appreciate the work we do. We have about 900 students turn up to school every day, and the role they play in making our school so great is never taken for granted. Thank you to all our young people. We are so very proud of you. Special thanks to our student leaders who dedicate extra energy in putting the needs of others in our school ahead of their own. Shortly, a pictorial collage will screen all that illustrates the colour and vibrancy of 2020. But in conclusion from me, we proved this year that this pandemic could not hold our faith story and our witness, nor our common ideals, worship and service. We still remain focused on harmonising every dimension of our being, and as a result, we are always prepared for every good work. Thank you and God bless.
Last year in Term 4 and this year in Term 1, a group of students worked really hard on our singing, dancing and acting in order to have The Sound of Music ready for production. We loved the rehearsal time. Sadly, it didn't happen, but we are so pleased that we're able to revisit two songs from production tonight. For our first song, please imagine a party at Captain Von Trapp's house and his children are about to go to bed.
Georg, I was wondering if the children could say goodnight to our guests the way they did for me last night.
No, Elsa, not here.
Oh, please, Georg, the way they did it for me, it was so sweet.
No, no, not in front of strangers.
Children, now.
This pretty sight.
So long, farewell, Avida. and you and you.
So long, farewell, au revoir, vie de say.
I'd like to stay and taste my first champagne. Yes?
No.
So long, farewell, I'll be to say goodbye.
I leave and heave a sigh and say goodbye. Goodbye!
I'm glad to go, I cannot tell a lie.
I flit, I float. I fleety flee, I fly.
The sun has gone to bed and so must I.
So long, farewell, of the
The S&C Senior Dance Team is comprised of students in years 10, 11, and 12. These students audition to be part of the team and work to extend their dance and performance skills. This year, their dance work, choreographed by Miss Albin, is titled Degeneration and explores the idea of climate change. It is based on a Cree Indian proverb that is stated at the beginning of the dance work and is spoken by Heather Brains.
When the last tree has been cut down, the last fish caught, the last river poisoned, only then will we realize we cannot eat money.
Just like the sea, I don't know where to go. Through dirt and shadow I grow. I'm reaching light through the struggle. Just like the sea, I'm chasing the wonder. I unravel myself. Slow motion.
You cannot eat money or not. You cannot eat money or not. When the last tree has fallen and the rivers are.
Suffocate me, so my tears can be rain. I will water the ground where I stand, so the flowers can grow back again. 'Cause just like the sea, everything wants to land. We are burning our fingers, but we learn and forget.
Teachers do a fantastic job at the college. Our community, staff, students, and parents are invited to nominate a teacher whom they feel has excelled in their work this year. It is my pleasure to introduce our prior, the Right Reverend Father Peter Joseph, who will talk to us about the winner of this year's Brother Patrick Doolan Award.
The Brother Patrick Doolan Award was inaugurated at St. Norbert College after the death of Brother Patrick at the beginning of 2006. It was designed to be a way to honour a staff member, teaching or non-teaching, who has been outstanding in the way that that person has approached life at St. Norbert College as a Catholic educational establishment. While almost everyone has seen 2020 as a time of challenge and disruption, it's also been a time of opportunity and adaptability. In all aspects of college life since March, every staff member has been placed in a position where each one has had to step up and step beyond what they know and are comfortable with. New ways of teaching, different ways of responding to the needs of students and parents, and one another have been the order of the day. Everything has not always gone perfectly. Lucky we're supposed to be lifelong learners. We've all learnt new ways of being prepared for all good works for and to each other. Our college values of adaptability and community have been particularly called for and celebrated. It's been a real privilege for me as the prior of the Norbertine community to see and appreciate all that the staff have done and been in 2020 for you, our students and parents, guardians and caregivers. How do you choose one person who has been an outstanding model of the very best of the St. Norbert College culture? You don't. So, the Brother Patrick Doolan Award for 2020 goes to all staff at St. Norbert College. Each one of you has been outstanding, brilliant, fabulous, true professionals. You deserve this. It's a shame that we are not in the concert hall to hear the applause. I sometimes think that as a larger community, we do not tell the staff how much we appreciate who they are and the efforts they make. Here is an opportunity in the coming weeks to actually say thanks and congratulations to staff as you meet them. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Peter. Interest for the Canons Hip Hop Crew proved to be very popular at auditions at the start of the year, and the crew has had a significant boost in numbers. This year, we have 38 students from years 7 to 12 involved, and the hip-hop crew captains, Patrick Ossius and Nicole Dubkowski, have done a fantastic job leading them, choreographing and creating an inclusive and welcoming environment. Their dance work is titled The Love Canon, and is based on the following intent. He's an icon, he's a smooth romantic, he's crazy in love. They're all looking for the one that makes their heart beat, legs groove and head bop. This is The Love Canon.
Welcome to Love Canons, where your love interest can groove it up, shake it up, and dance all night long.
Let's bring on our first contestant. He's furious,
He's energetic. Let's bring on Isaiah!
I'm just an icon living. Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Ooh. Interview, cover 5 minutes. Ooh. We are too hot in the business. Ooh. I'm going straight to the top of the cool. We should just chill and maybe take it slow. Before we get up there with nowhere to go. And we can chill and just look at the view. Woo!
We interrupt this program to bring you a
squad.
Hey, yo, let's bring on our next contestant. He's groovy, he's cool. Bring on Patrick.
Do 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 do. Yay. Yeah. Tell me, fellas, have you seen her? It was about 5 minutes ago when I seen the hottest chick that a youngin' never seen before. So she get it, there she is, I gotta stop her. Oh yeah.
I know you're tryna leave. Excuse me, miss. I saved the last dance for you.
I would love to keep you here with me, baby.
Hey yo, let's bring out our last contestant. He's sassy, he's groovy. We give you Jordan!
So deep in your eyes, I touch on you more and more every time. When you leave, I'm begging you not to go. Call your name 2-3 times in a row. Such a funny thing for me to try to explain. How I'm feeling and my pride is the one to blame. Cause I know I don't understand just how your love can do it, no one else can.
Got me looking so crazy right.
One of the major awards that a student can be presented with at the college is the Principal's Medallions. These are given to a student in Year 12 who has been nominated for all the work they've done during their time at the college. This year, we chose not to let the winners know beforehand, so tonight will be a surprise for them as well. I now invite Mr. Harvey to announce the winners of these medallions.
Principal's Medallions are awarded to Year 12 students who have shown outstanding leadership and service at St. Norbert College. This evening, we are awarding 6 senior students for their contribution to our college. They have all been exemplary role models for all students by always using their gifts and talents for the benefit of all. They have lived the college motto of being prepared for all good works. Our first recipient of a Principal's Medallion has made a significant contribution to all areas of college life, most noticeably in the areas of academics, arts, and leadership. During her time at the college, she has received numerous academic awards, including academic distinctions and ad omnia paratus, culminating in academic honours this year. In the area of performing arts, she has been a member of the dance team and received dance honours, having performed in numerous Catholic performing arts festivals. She has been a leader and role model and was a member of the Student Representative Council for 3 years, as well as a committee member for her house, assisting with college events and supporting her fellow students. Representing the college in a variety of sporting teams and academic competitions, including Rostrum Voice of Youth, this recipient was named the Phil Mountford Leadership Award winner in Year 9 and won the ADF Long Tan Leadership Award in Year 10. She has been an outstanding Tongalo captain this year. Congratulations, Anissa Buckby. Our second recipient has proven to be an outstanding role model to both her peers and the wider community. Her selfless nature is evident through involvement in several services to the college and community, most notably the college choir, the media team, soccer, open day, and competitions such as the Brain Bee Challenge and Australian History Competition. She was also in the college production of Oliver and received dance honours for contributions to the hip hop crew. This student's leadership qualities developed through involvement in student ministry, the Student Representative Council, and her house committee. A tireless work ethic and reliability are noticeable traits. Most recently, she produced the Year 12 graduation video despite being committed to a demanding academic program. A humble leader appointed Magdeburg House Captain for 2020. Congratulations, Jen Hannah Durang. A gifted and dedicated student academically, our next recipient has been recognised with numerous academic awards reflecting both his endeavour and achievement. It is, however, in serving his fellow students, especially in his house, that his passion and commitment has been most noticeable. This student is an outstanding role model, always impeccably presented, trustworthy and responsible with a warm and caring nature, highlighted by participation in the Student Mental and Wellbeing Seminar to be a mental health first aider for his peers. He has represented the college in the String Ensemble, ACC Cross Country, Pedal Pre, Open Days, Rostrum Voice of Youth, Science Cafe, Youth Civic Leadership Day, and Have Some Fun. He has won numerous academic awards, including Academic Distinctions and Ad Omnia Paratus, and was awarded Academic Honours this year. He is a mature and responsible young adult, displaying outstanding interpersonal and leadership skills. He has been very supportive of the college through his active involvement and exceptional leadership in the House Committee, and this year as Kilnacrot House Captain. He recently won the John Pollaers Medal for his contributions to Kilnacrot House. Congratulations, Lorenzo Donatelli. The fourth recipient of a Principal's Medallion has always shown herself to be a reliable, honest and hardworking student, exhibiting a genuine willingness to serve and help others. She has been an excellent role model for the students at the college in terms of behaviour, personal presentation and punctuality. This student has taken advantage of the opportunity to involve herself in the Catholic traditions of the college through ongoing participation and commitment to student ministry. She is always willing to help those around her, also undertaking the Teen Mental Health First Aid training to support her peers. Her hardworking attitude is reflected by the various awards received, including Academic Distinctions, Ad Omnia Paratus, and awards for excellence and outstanding application. She has competed in the Australian Maths Competition, Maths Olympiad, Big Science Competition, and the Australian History Competition. Her leadership qualities are of the highest standards, always leading by example. She was a member of the Student Representative Council, Student Ministry, and her House Committee. She is thorough in all she does, and this was reflected in her planning of SRC events, as well as her leadership role in Kairos 27. Awarded the Phil Mountford Leadership Award in Year 10 and selected as the Magdeburg College Captain for Year 12 are indicative of this recipient's personality, characterised by the most noblest of qualities, honesty, generosity and humility. Congratulations, Isabella Fico. Our next recipient is a reflective, considerate and organised student who has always shown concern for the pastoral needs of her fellow students. She has been a part of the student ministry team since Year 7, displaying a caring attitude and an aptitude to work to meet the needs of others with an unwavering sense of justice and compassion. It was these qualities that motivated her to complete the Teen Mental Health First Aid program. It is in the arts where her passions lie. She has been an active member of the college chorale, liturgical music, tap troupe, and drama club, receiving drama honours for her commitment and contributions, as well as being awarded the St John of God Healthcare Performing Arts Scholarship in 2018. A great ambassador for the college, she hosted a presentation night and assisted in open days, She was an outstanding student leader for the Kairos 27 retreat, displaying exemplary organisational skills, reliability, innovation, and great empathy for others. She is a wonderful mentor and role model for younger students, an outstanding vice captain for Premontre House, most recently awarded the Lanny Rowell Award for her contributions to her house. Congratulations, Courtney McCrosty. Our final recipient of a Principal's Medallion is a humble leader who gives his time and energy to others, never seeking accolades or titles for his efforts. Of particular note is his contribution to the arts, sport, and Christian witness. This student has been a key member of the Canons hip hop crew since year 7. He has choreographed and trained the group, devoting countless hours despite a heavy academic workload. His natural talent in music was on display at music nights, assemblies, lunchtime concerts, the Catholic Performing Arts Festival, and the Australian Catholic Youth Festival. This year, he was given the role of the guitar ensemble captain, where he encouraged, taught, and supported younger students. His commitment to the arts was recognised, receiving honours for both dance and music. He has also contributed in the arena of sport, being selected to represent the college in the ACC Athletics and Cross Country teams and the AFL Dockers Shield team. Attending Kairos 27 and Christian service at the Harold Hawthorne Centre are just a small part of his service to others. He has been an altar server at many college liturgies and continues to look out for the welfare of those disadvantaged in the wider community. His acts of generosity, particularly to the homeless in his local area, are not known to many. His talent in design has been prominent in creative arts exhibitions, and most recently, he has quietly assisted in filming teams for the Torn of the Minds and produced the video for the Year 12 Assembly. Congratulations, Patrick Osius. That concludes the special awards for our Year 12 students. Please join me in congratulating all recipients.
Thank you, Mr. Harvey, and congratulations to all the winners of the Principal's Medallions. It is certainly something that we should all aspire to do. Our house system works very well at the college, and it is now my pleasure to introduce our Deputy Principal, Mr. Hawke, to announce the college captains for next year.
It gives me great pleasure to announce our student leaders for 2021. Zanton College Captain, Sophia Jaffray, and the Zanton Vice Captains, Lacey Ann Clements and Tiana Suckling. Premontre College Captain Nicole Vlahov and the Premontre Vice Captains Alina George and Chloe Delu. Magdeburg College Captain Ariel Chant and the Magdeburg Vice Captains Sabita Rajal and Curtis Eyre. Tongolo College Captain Matilda Cerrone and the Tongolo Vice Captains Gigi Amenti and Joshua Ferguson. Kilnacrock College Captain Sydney Midgley and the Kilnacrock Vice Captains Paul Fuentes and Zeta Stevens. And the Specialist College Captains for 2021. Student Ministry, Ali Koch. Student Representative Council, Alice O'Malley. Arts, Curtis Blackwood. Media, Anushka Kotian. Sport, Courtney Fitzgerald. Please congratulate our student leaders for 2021.
I now invite Father Peter to present the Student Ministry Award.
Student Ministry Award is presented to a student who stands out in terms of demonstrating mature leadership and a strong commitment to student ministry activities at the college. This year's recipient of the Student Ministry Award has always been a willing member of student ministry throughout her years at the college and has generously used her gifts and talents to participate in the liturgical celebrations within the college, participated in service learning activities, and encouraged other students to do the same. Facilitated small guided meditation sessions for extended homeroom, and was pivotal in making this year's Catholic Agency's winter appeal the success that it was. A student of deep faith, this recipient has put that faith into action at school and in her own church community, highlighted by participation in a Cambodian immersion with her church earlier this year. Her efforts are an inspiration for others. Congratulations to a true servant leader, Ariana Tilley.
We do have one more item for you from The Sound of Music, But before we present that, we just wanted to let you know that all of the year awards will be available for you to see after that item. We hope you watch them all.
Now, the students who have received awards know who they are, but no one knows who has won the Proxima Akeset and the Ducks for each year, so you'll have to watch the awards to find that out.
Before we get to the last item of the evening, we wanted to show you a wonderful present that the Year 12 students gave the college this year.
Knowing that next year is the 900th anniversary of the Norbertine Canons, it is a beautiful reminder for us and also something to really look forward to celebrating next year. The last song from The Sound of Music is beautiful and a really nice way to lead into our awards. The Von Trapp family and Maria are hiding in the convent garden, hoping to flee and to be able to keep the family together. Please sit back and enjoy Climb Every Mountain.
Thank you to everyone who has been involved in the presentation night this year. There have been many people working behind the scenes and we thank them all, especially Mr. Dowling and the presentation night committee. We hope you've enjoyed this first part of the evening and we know you are eager to watch the awards as well.